This is another A2 card, and this is on, I believe this is MFT Hot Chocolate cardstock that I used for the card base. The cardstock is in my mind's eye, Fine and Dandy Girl, maybe, I think. Some small flower breads up here. This is a glitter paper. It's kind of a blue-gray, but the glitter on it is that aqua kind of color, so I thought it pulled that aqua color from her coloring in. Some striped ribbon and a Martha Stewart, the lace border punch. Again, the ticket and the Enjoy is another Amy R. Big Words and Handy Editions stamp. I used the swirl glitter glue on her hair bows, and then on the cherry there's just a tiny little dot of glossy accents. She is colored with the Letraset Pro markers, and this is the Spellbinders Lacy Ovals die. And again, it's blank, and I just used, this is a Martha Stewart, one of the larger Martha Stewart lace punches. It's this one. It's not the one that I thought it was. And I just covered up the center with the ribbon. And then used another piece on the inside. And again, when I decide who it's going to, I will do the sentiment on the inside. Sorry, I have a mess now. There we go. The next one is on white cardstock. It's another A2 card edged in black soot. The last one was edged in walnut stain. Some black and white baker's twine. This is a Martha Stewart punch that actually is two layers. There's a layer here and then the bottom layer. This is from that three-ticket EK Success punch, and it's stamped with Happy Birthday. It's stamped in black. It's a little hard to read. I colored this Greeting Farm image. It's a digital image available from them, and I colored it with the Letraset Pro markers. Three small square brads, and the paper here is from Basic Gray Indie Chic collection and edged in black soot. And the pattern paper layer is up on dimensionals off of the white cardstock. And then blank inside. I don't have very many baby stamps, so I don't have very many baby cards made up. So this is another digital image from the Greeting Farm, colored with the Letraset Pro markers. That's up on dimensionals above the pattern paper. And these pattern papers, I believe, are also K & Company Sweet Nectar. And some turquoise cardstock. The Sweet New Baby is from Amy R's Big Words and Handy Edition set. It's great for cards. It's got tons of sentiments. I'm so glad that I picked that up. Some small bronze brads here. This turquoise backed layer that the bear is on is also raised up on dimensionals from the background pattern paper. There's some vintage turquoise rickrack going along behind, and then it's on a craft cardstock base, and everything's edged in the walnut stain, and then again blank inside. I also decided to do a couple seasonal cards. This is an image that I colored last year with the Prismacolor colored pencils blended with the mineral spirits. That is on a Labels 1, I believe it is, Spellbinders Nestability that I ran. It's a coordinations that I ran through the Cuddlebug and then just sanded the dots a little bit. I put that on some purple cardstock, and it's the back of the coordinations, and then just cut a small border, edged everything with black soot. This is a Martha Stewart spiderweb punch. Trick or Treat is, I think it's from either an Inka Dinka Do set or one of the dollar stamps from Joann's. The orange Halloween spiderweb paper is from a matte stack. I think it's Cloud 9. It had fall and Halloween and Christmas all in it, all together. Some black ribbon. It's half sheer, half satin with a iridescent thread running through the center. Some more of the Martha Stewart spiderweb. And then I used the gel pen, the Clear Star. Clear Star gel pen on the letters and on the spider webs to give them a little bit of sparkle, and also use the black soot on the edge. And the orange pattern paper is on dimensionals. The Trick or Treat is on dimensionals. And then added a couple black pearls to the embossed spider up here in the corner. And then the inside is blank. The next one is a digital image that I found online. I'm not sure where. I've lost everything on my old laptop. I haven't had the chance to take it up to see if they can retrieve anything off of it. But this is an image that I colored with the Letraset Pro markers. That's on, I believe it's the label one, Spellbinder's Nestability. Cut a border around the black with some green. Everything's edged in black soot distress ink. The green layer is popped up on dimensionals. Then this is also from the same, I think it's Cloud 9 stack that had the different holidays in it. It's a matte stack. The black glitter bat sticker, it's a foam sticker. I'm not sure. Trying to think, Spook Alley might be the collection. I'm not sure who made that, if it was Making Memories. Some purple sparkly twill ribbon here. I took the Martha Stewart Drippy Goo Punch and cut it out of the black cardstock, and then also put glossy accents on it. And then down here is another one from Dollar Stamp. It says, "Too Cute to Spook," with a couple little black brads. Everything's edged in black soot, and the inside of this is also blank. This is Seymour the Penguin. This is a stamp from Stamper's Best. He is colored with Letraset Pro markers. He's on an oval, and the oval and the white layer are cut out of one of the MFT label dies. There's three pieces to the set. I cut some paper to match and just ran that, made a slit through the white layer and ran that through. Everything's edged in black soot. A couple little candy canes and a sparkly red pom-pom. And this is also from the Cloud 9 paper set. The red polka dot is from, I think it's Cosmo Cricut Mitten Weather. I think it's the polka dot is from. And then the inside is also blank. This is the other image of Seymour from Stamper's Best. Very similar layout to the last one, colored with the Pro markers, raised up on dimensionals, the blue layer. The white layer is raised up on dimensionals. These papers, I think, are from Eskimo Kisses from Basic Gray. Everything's edged in black soot, white cardstock for the last two cards for the base, and it's empty inside, blank inside. So, those are the cards that I've been doing in the last few weeks while I've been recuperating, and I hope you enjoyed them. I'll be back with a TP mini that I made after being inspired by Anastasia's videos and her series that she just did with her toilet paper roll mini. So I'll be back to show you that, and I hope you have a good evening. Good night.